Two of those banks, Bank of America and Citi, also told investors today to expect weaker trading revenue in the fourth quarter. The chief executives of both companies made the disclosures at a financial conference in New York City, and Kayla Tausche was there.
The Goldman Sachs Financial Services Conference is underway in New York, with bank executives taking the opportunity to warn investors about some weakness coming up in the fourth quarter. Citigroup CEO Michael Corbat announcing a $3.5 billion charge the bank will be taking. $2.7 billion of that will be related to legal matters like ongoing investigations into alleged currency and interest rate manipulation. Also, there's an investigation ongoing into anti-money laundering practices. $800 million of that charge will go toward existing repositioning at the bank. But in all, Corbat's telling investors it's unpredictable, especially where legal issues are concerned, because the leverage for pricing and for timing all lay with the U.S. government. Meanwhile, Bank of America CEO Brian Moynihan telling investors that trading revenues for the fourth quarter will be down compared to the third quarter of this year, as well as the same quarter a year ago. The main culprit there, ultra-low interest rates, yields that tested October lows. That is keeping traders on the sideline, and they do not want to play this volatility. The bright spot for all the banks presenting at the conference seems to be low oil prices. SunTrust CEO Bill Rogers says lower prices at the pump could save the average U.S. household up to $1,500.
It's essentially a refund, and I think that's going to have to impact consumer confidence in some way. I think we'll see it with increased spending. We'll see an increased use of credit card utilization.
The hope that higher confidence spurs consumer spending and could possibly lift some of the weaker businesses at these banks. For Nightly Business Report, I'm Kayla Tausche in New York.